Hi, Charles. Okay. This morning when I was doing a potato review, I mentioned on that channel that my daughter was getting into medieval cookery and she wanted me to make a pestle and mortar for her because she wants to grind her own herbs and make up her own sauces, right? What you make with it? Mixed oil tinctures and stuff like that. There would be whatever you do for cooking anyway. So I got a piece. I wanted to keep it fairly simple because in medieval times they would have had pole lays and foot powered, so they wouldn't have time or energy to waste putting a lot of design on something. So I went for a very simple form with, I used maple for that, or sycamore. So that's it. It's about 6 inches in diameter. And I left the base I just sanded that to 120 because I didn't want it to move about. And then the sides, the hardest part of this was getting the sides square, and then it just hollowed out the inside to about 3 inches deep, about 2.5 inches deep on the inside there. And then I made the pestle. I made a fairly substantial one with a fairly big bulb at the end to go in there. And the radius matches pretty well. How am I going to show this? The radius matches pretty well, but it leaves a little space underneath. It's just a slightly tighter radius than this, so the actual herbs can get underneath it to get crushed. I made one time and I got the radius absolutely perfect to the inside circumference of the mortar. But then you couldn't grind properly because you'd none of this activity here. Every time you put it in, you couldn't get a squashing action because you were all trying to squash everything at once. So you need that sort of lever thing to break these herbs up. So you make your inside radius a bit tighter than the radius of the bowl in the middle. The first, that's the second one I made, which I think is the best one. It's about 6 inches long. I split the difference. I made it with a fairly sort of average size end there and a slightly smaller end there. And they both fit in, a fairly nice fit inside the bowl. How am I going to show that? Yeah, inside the bowl. They're not a bad fit at all, we just see now. That's it. So that's it. So that's the medieval pestle and mortar. So I'm sending that off to my daughter on Monday. I said to the table this morning I had already done that, but when I got into the car this morning I'd been down to the shop and came home and looked and the parcel was still sitting in the back of the car. I thought I'd posted it. So I opened it up again just to show you what it was. I'm going to make one of these. They're fairly straightforward and I'll make one of those soon because I've got the blanks and all here. Okay, all the best now. Bye bye.